When you're looking to add a discount, offering a sale price to anyone who views a product on your store, there are a couple of quick tweaks to make it happen, and you can make these tweaks from the product itself. Simply, if your item is priced at $100, but you want to sell it for $80, just change the price to $80. That's it. Except it isn't. A very common workflow is to make the original price the compare-at price. Why? Because in most sales, we'll want to display the original price. The item is now $80, it's on sale. And we want to compare that, we want to show the original price is $100. That's how we add sale prices. What else can we do with this newly acquired skill? We can add a sale banner. We'll just drag in a text block from our ad panel. And once we drag it in, we'll edit it. We'll simply write out on sale. Why? Because the item's on sale. And we can style it however we'd like. We can modify the colors, just go in and change the background color to something, maybe a blue. And notice how changes on this sale banner are affecting the sale banners on each product, changes like padding. We can position it on the top right. And what we'll do for this is use position absolute, because we want to position the on sale banner on the top right here. Remember, position absolute requires that one of its parent elements, in this case, it's each of the products, position absolute requires one of its parents to have relative positioning, or really any positioning that isn't auto. We can tweak it, we can move it, but we might also realize it's showing up on every product. It's showing up even though some of these things aren't on sale. We only want this element, the on sale banner, we only want it visible if we've gone in and actually added a compare at price. So all we have to do is set conditional visibility. Basically, this means we're only going to show it, the sale banner, if our product, the product that's on sale, actually has a compare at price. That means the banner will only show up for products that have a compare at price listed. Finally, let's look at how we can show the compare at price on the product page. Just like any text item, we can drag in a text block, or this could also be a heading or anything with text. We can drag in a text block and connect it. We can get that text from the compare at price. Why is that important? We're showing the sale price, the current price, but we probably want to show the old price, the compare at price, and then style it a bit. We're just styling the compare at price. And by the way, this applies to every product that has a compare at price. It works for all of them. Just make sure if you're creating something that you only want to show up on product pages that have a compare at price, make sure you use the same trick as before. Set a condition. The element is visible only when the compare at price is set. And you can find creative ways to show the original price, like adding strikethroughs, or going in and displaying the original price, or binge watching the first four seasons of The West Wing, then going in and displaying the original price. That's the big picture. That's an overview of sale prices in Webflow Ecommerce.